clear, I think. Now, two cases of concave lenses. Concave lens. How the ray diagrams are drawn in case of concave lenses? There are only two cases for concave lens. When the object is at infinity, first case, at infinity. Here what happens? Do you remember what is the shape of the concave lens? It is thicker at the edges and thinner in the center or the middle. Principal axis, this is optical center, this is F1, this is 2F1 and this is F2, this is 2F2. Okay, the object is placed here at infinity. We will show it like this. Now, one of the rays, this one, another ray is this one. It will come to the optical center. These are the incident rays. Now what will happen? These are diverging lenses. If you remember, we discussed last class. So here, the reflection will take place. They are going to move away. In this case, they were meeting at the point of F2. But here, they are moving away. So what we are going to do? We are going to extend them like this then. No other option. Okay. So this is the point where the image is formed. And it is forming on the which side? On the left hand side of the lens, where the object is placed, on that side only. So, we will write here, what is the position at, position of the image formed at F1. What is the size? It is highly diminished. Okay, highly diminished or point sized, or we can write point sized. Then what is the nature? Actual refracted rays, they are moving apart. We are extending them, making them virtually meet here. So the nature is virtual and erect. Virtual and erect. So this is the first case of concave lens. Then second case, when the object is kept anywhere between infinity and optical center. Okay, so when the object is kept where? At infinity and the optical center. So in that case, how it takes place? Between infinity and optical center. This is the location of the object. Let us again draw the diagram of a concave lens. This is concave lens. Principal axis, optical center, F1, 2F1, it is F2 and 2F2. So what is going to happen here? Let us keep it here. One of the rays parallel to principal axis. So what will happen to it? It is going to diverge. The another ray is which is passing through the optical center. In this case also, the optical center, when the ray is passing through, yesterday we discussed, if you remember, it will move away without undeviated. Okay, so where the ray is going to form? This is going this way. This ray through optical center is going this way. So they are moving apart. Where they are going to meet? Never. So, What is the other option? We are going to extend it. So this is the point where they are intersecting. The virtually extended ray, okay, which is passing through F1, and the one which is passing through optical center. So here is the image formed. This is. So what is the position? What is the position? We can write between F1 and O. Size diminished as compared to the object, it is very small. Diminished. And the nature, can you see it is upright? So it is virtual and erect. It is virtual and erect. So this is how only two cases will be there. Wherever you keep, the position of the image form will be same only. Do you remember the convex mirror? In that also we had only two cases, at infinity or between infinity and the pole of the mirror. Here, either at infinity or between infinity and optical center. You can keep it here. If you will keep it here, then also same thing. If you keep it here, there, then also same thing. So every time we are going to have the same type of image formed. So only two cases, at infinity and between infinity and optical center. So practice them. So today's homework is to practice these ray diagrams, all the 8 cases, 6 cases of convex lens and 2 cases of concave lens. Draw with the help of a scale, sharp pencil. Minimum use of eraser should be there, and don't forget to put arrows. These are the important things that you need to keep in mind. Don't forget to put arrows for incident as well as refracted rays. And the distance taken for all these terminologies should be equal. Fine? So, do this.